My iPhone tells me I've taken 3,414 steps today, but can I trust it? That's something researchers at UBC wanted to find out.
Come on in, Yingying. So we're going to be doing the laboratory test today.
For researchers, the iPhone seems like a very useful tool because a lot of people already have smartphones, and it'll be an easy and effective way for us to measure physical activity in a wide group of people. So when participants came in for the initial lab test, we had them walk at four different speeds, ranging from 2.5 to 10 kilometers an hour. The iPhone missed about 9% of steps at the slowest speed, 2.5 kilometers. However, at 5 kilometers and above, the iPhone performed reasonably well with less than 5% of steps missed, which we actually consider to be very acceptable for a research-grade pedometer. But because the whole point of using smartphones for physical activity surveillance is to examine real-life application, we added this free living part of the research experiment. What we did is we provided participants with a research-grade accelerometer, and they were instructed to use their iPhone as they typically would. And then we compared the step counts generated by the accelerometer for each day to the step counts generated by the iPhone for the same days. The free living test, the iPhone underestimated steps by about 1,000 to 1,200 steps per day. So the iPhone may not be the greatest at recording some of these slower walking speeds, but for the individual user, it's probably a very useful tool for goal setting and increasing physical activity.